إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد، فيقول الحق سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, we welcome all of you in the day of Jum'ah, the best day that the sun rising, the best day of the whole week that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blessed the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Yawm al-Jum'ah, the day of forgiveness, the day of rahmah, the day of istighfar, the day of answering our dua. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Al-Jumu'atu ila al-Jumu'ah mukaffiratun lima baynahun idha tunibatil kabair. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Salatul Jumu'ah to Salatul Jumu'ah, the day of Jumu'ah to the day of Jumu'ah will be a forgiveness for the Muslim if he avoiding the kabair, the major of the sins. But still, minor ones, major ones, is the khuta of the shaitan, is the steps of the shaitan. The true Muslim, the Muslim who's looking for the haqq, for the iman, for the deen, he's staying away from any steps that the shaitan will call us to. Allahumma qina azab al-nar. Allahumma qina azab al-nar. Today, after this preface, this introduction, we'll come to one of the topics that the Muslim should always remember. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, أَكْثِرُ مِنْ ذِكْرِ هَادِمِ اللَّزَّاتِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, mention, remember much, remember a lot, هَادِمُ اللَّزَّاتِ, the one is gonna call everyone at any moment without any appointment. Of course, everyone now understands what I'm gonna talk about. سكرات الموت, the stupor of the death will come with the حق. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في الكتاب العزيز, وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد. These ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it, send it down with Jibril alayhi salam, with the wahi to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Quran will be reciting, will be memorizing until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the permission to Yawm al-Qiyamah to take place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, the stupor of death, sakaratul maut, the pain of death, the privation of death, the permission for malak al-maut to take place with each soul of Bani Adam. And this will be the haqq, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call himself to al-haqq. Yaqul Rabbuna subhanahu ذلك بأن الله هو الحق. Every Muslim should know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is al-haqq. You live, you die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala هو الحق. وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك, this truth, this haqq, ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد. You avoid it to think about it, you avoid to talk about it, you avoid to say to yourself, to reflect, to think that it will take place. ونفخ في الصور, that will come after that. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, ما منكم من أحد إلا وسيكلمه ربه دون ترجمان. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بالسيد in the hadith, each one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will speak to, everyone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will speak to. There is no turjuman. Turjuman means no one will come in the middle to explain what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. What Allah he will say in this hadith, he will remind you on the dhunub, on the sins. You did it yesterday, you did it today, and you may do it tomorrow. The dhunub, the ma'asi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind you, ya abdi, you did so and so on that day. How are you gonna answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What answer you will say? Ya Rabbi, I have to do it. Ya Rabbi, my iman short. My iman is short. My heart used to. What type of answer you will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What type of answer you preparing at this moment? Why you hear this ayat to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about every haram took place in your book of amal? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتقوا النار, اتقوا النار, اتقوا النار. He said it three times. ولو بشق تمرة, even with half of a date. The tam, we eat it. The date we eat. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, stay away. Fear the torment of Jahannam, even with half a date. How Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his pain for his ummah, his worry about his ummah. Not only that will take place. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ. In أرض المحشر, the day of gathering, يوم القيامة. سبحان الله, something
It will take place. Everyone, the mu'min, the asir, the muti', the kafir, when your time comes to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and meet for the hisab to angels, they gonna take place with everyone. One will drive you to the hisab. معها سائق وشهيد. The next angel will come to stand as a witness when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind you of your dhunub and your sins. How is the haqq? How is the adl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah will take place? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at this moment, as today, before yawm al-qiyamah will take place, before this haqq will take place, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ. This Qur'an guide the mu'mineen, the believers of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the most just and the most right. وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Al-Qur'an give a glad tiring for Jannah, for the great reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next ayat, وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Those who avoid to think about Akhirah, about the Al-Qabr, about سؤال الملكين, about ملك الموت. وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prepared a severe, a painful torment every Muslim also should know that الدُّنْيَا زَائِلَةً. Keep that haqiqah, this fact in your aqd, in your deen, in your iman. Dunya, it will leave. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْقِ. Ya Muhammad, even you are my prophet, my messenger, but not before you will stay ever and ever. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْقِ. So, with the love I give you, أَفَإِنْ مِتْ, if the death took place with you, they're gonna stay, they're gonna die too. But subhanAllah, the haqq is, the haqiqah is, really, you think about it? Really, you ready for it? As one of the men came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, Ya Muhammad, ماذا الساعة? When yawm al-qiyamah will take place? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَاذَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا? You ask about الساعة. You ask about the timing of yawm al-qiyamah. But what did you prepare for it? This is the true answer. Nowadays also, we and our family, how much you prepare for yawm al-qiyamah? Your son, your daughter, your wife, your brother, your sister. What we prepare for yawm al-qiyamah before it will take place. Wallahi, mount itself is not the matter. But do you know what's gonna take place after mount? Do you know what it will take place after death? Yes. Qabr. Grave. Dhammat al-qabr. Adab al-qabr. Su'al al-malakayn in the qabr. Al-qabr. Idha al-rawdatum min riyad al-jannah. أو حفرة من حفر النيران. This is حق. Until يوم القيامة. Then it will be يوم القيامة taking place. إسرافيل عليه السلام will blow the صور, the trumpet. Then الصراط. Then جهنم. Then the نار. As رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, every abd will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will look at the right, he's gonna see Jannah. He's gonna look at left, he will see Jahannam. He's gonna look at front, he's gonna see his amal. قال سبحانه وتعالى وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه. Every abd, every insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him his book. ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. اقرأ كتابك يا عدي يا عبد الله. Allah will tell you, read your book, read your book. كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. You will be a hasib on yourself. يقول سبحانه وتعالى about that ما أغنى عني مالية هلك عني سلطانية خذوه فغلوه ثم الجحيم صلوه ثم في سلسلة ذرعها 70 ذراعا فاسلكوه إنه كان لا يؤمن بالله العظيم. يوم القيامة the عبد of Allah سبحانه وتعالى will say, يا ربي nothing will help me, my sultan, my position, my kip, my prowess, my علم, nothing. هلك عني سلطان. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى he will say to the عصاة خذوه فغلوه. Lock him or her to جهنم. ثم الجحيم صلوه. ثم في سلسلة شن ذرعها 70 ذراعا. It will go up to 70 arms. This is the chin. ثم الجحيم صلوه. ثم في سلسلة ذرعها 70 ذراعا فاسلكوه. يا ربي, why all this type of torment and punishment? Because he heard in the haqq. He didn't apply it. But alhamdulillah, the other side. فأما من أوتي بكتابه بيمينه. You know الأرض المحشر, يوم القيامة. When the believers, the صالحين, will collect their books with the right hand. It's a good news. Whoever will collect, who will get his book with the right hand, who will go back to the believer who didn't have the hisab yet. فيقول ها أمو اقرأوا كتابية إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابية. He will go back to them who standing waiting for the hisab. He will tell them, see what happened. I take my book, alhamdulillah, with my right hand. Because I used to have the yaqeen, the haqq, that I will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's so happy. He's so excited. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. He will be in a pleasant life. فهو في جنة عالية قطوفها دانية كلوا إيه واشربوا drink هنيئا هنيئا to every عبد, every Muslim. He fears Allah سبحانه وتعالى today. هنيئا for the صالحين, هنيئا for أهل الفردوس الأعلى, هنيئا for those who apply the Quran and Sunnah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in their عمل, in their life, in their family, in every word, the tongue will say it. هنيئا. بما أسلفتم في الأيام الخالية. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وبعد. الفضيل ابن عياض ولد الصالحين ونس يمين I would like to ask his brother please can you can move up to this brother who comes late they're gonna have the room to sit and have Salat al-Jumu'ah. Listen to this ilm, this interview. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad asked that man, Ya Abdullah, kam umruk? How old are you? We ask everyone, friends, relatives, friends, anyone, how old are you? You answer, that's it. But how Al-Fudayl took that answer and he explained it with the ilm he had. He told him, the man told Al-Fudayl, Umri, 60 sana, my age, 60 years. He told him, so, you are for 60 years walking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, the man cried. He told him, Ya Fudayl, wa mal hila? So what I should do? He told him, Ya Abdullah, ilzam, ilzam al-haqq. So, whatever our age today, whatever your age today, how long now you walk into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? 50 years? 40 years? 35? 30? 20? We walk into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When that walk is gonna stop? We don't know. But it will come. Harun al-Rashid, this man, this Khalifa, he has big, huge, a major kingdom. You know how he used to talk? He used to say to the cloud, when rain sin down, he used to say to the cloud, he's speaking to the cloud, see how power he had? He said, send your rain anywhere, whatever, food, fruit, it will come, it will grow, it will come to me. Once, in the Marad al-Mawt, the sickness of the death, he said, carry me to see my grave before I die. Harun, the brother, please come, can just walk, make a room for the brother to come in, inshallah. Harun said, carry me, take me to see my grave, my qabr, before Malak al-Mat will come. Then he saw his qabr. He said, a great war. His heart cried, crying. Then he looked at the sky. Then he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb, irham man zala mulku. Ya man la yazulu mulku. Irham man zala mulku. O Allah, which is anta. Al-baqi, have your mercy on me. This is the iman. This is the khawf. Do you say these words every moment, or at least before you put your head in the bed, saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if this is my last night in this dunya, oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, have mercy on me. This is how the Muslim should think and make sure he ends his time with al-amal al-salih. The last point of the khutbah today, Jannah, food, clothes, mata', hur al-'ayn, all that is good. Every Muslim dreaming that he will go to Jannah, even if he doesn't do anything good. Everyone, he's dreaming, he's planning, he's gonna be in Jannah number one. But he doesn't know that not everyone will be in the Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about al-Jannah, sid'atullah ghaliya. Jannah is not cheap. Jannah expensive. Jannah expensive. But still, the last point of the khutbah, as I said, all this in Jannah is okay. But something, it will take place. Much better, much better, much better than all that. يقول سبحانه وتعالى وجوه يومئذ ناظرة أهل الجنة. Their wujuh has light, has pride. What else? إلى ربها ناظرة. This is the news. The good news for every believer who's sitting, listening to the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةً. Every Muslim, every mu'min in Jannah will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best and best to see Rabbuna subhanahu wa ta'ala. What else? What else you need? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you to see Him. يقول الله سبحانه للذين أحسنوا الحسنى. For the believers, الحسنى الجنة وزيادة. قال الله سبحانه, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم about the tafsir of the word زيادة in this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will make the believers, the mu'mineen fi al-jannah, to see Him. What else you want? That's why I'm saying food, hur al-'ayn, mata', all the pleasant things you're gonna have in Jannah, it is something, yes. But to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Jannah, this is something else. Only will be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the believer of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We end this khutbah with the dua. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma arina wajhaka al-kareem. Allahumma arina wajhaka al-kareem. Allahumma arzuqna al-haqqa wa atba'a. Allahumma arina wajhaka al-kareem wa arzuqna al-haqqa wa atba'a. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina. وثبت على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اشف أمراضنا, اللهم اشف أمراضنا وارحم أمواتنا وبارك لنا في بيوتنا وأزواجنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا من كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا في يومنا هذا واختم لنا بالباقيات الصالحات. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.